Consider the following hypothetical scenario. Dr. T.H.E. Hotshot is writing a paper about how coastal marshes respond to sea level rise. He has recently published another paper on the same topic. In the new paper, he plans to use a few paragraphs from the published paper's introduction because the basic information and rationale for the research are similar. In such a situation, what should Dr. Hotshot do? One, use the original text verbatim and without citing the published paper because he is reusing his own words and need not cite himself. Two, paraphrase the published text but without citing the original paper because he is rephrasing his own words. Three, paraphrase the published text and cite the original paper. Four, use the original text, but place it in quotation marks and cite the original paper. Hi, I'm Karen McKee, and today I'll be talking about self-plagiarism. What is it, and why should you be concerned about it? We'll come back to the hypothetical scenario and consider the four possible responses a bit later. But first, let's define self-plagiarism. Plagiarism happens when someone deliberately uses another author's work without crediting them. This may be a word-for-word copy of the other person's text, or a paraphrase of another's wording or ideas without citing the original author. Self-plagiarism happens when you reuse your own text from a previous publication without letting the reader know. While it's clear that republishing an entire paper in a second journal is unethical, less clear are situations involving reuse of a few paragraphs or sentences. Using portions of text from your own previous work, especially without attribution, can give the reader the false impression that the information is new. And, depending on the amount and type of text reused, the reuse may be considered copyright infringement by the publisher of the original paper. Self-plagiarism is a term that implies misconduct, which is confusing because there are some instances in which it's appropriate to reuse one's own work. Consequently, some experts suggest using the term text recycling instead. Typically, text recycling most often involves descriptions of study sites, laboratory setups, analytical protocols, or statistical tests that are the same across multiple publications. Usually, there are only a few ways to word such descriptions, and paraphrasing may inadvertently remove or minimize key details, thereby reducing the reader's comprehension of what was done. Thus, many authors and journals consider recycling of selected methods descriptions to be acceptable. Authors may also reuse portions of a literature review from a grant proposal in a subsequent journal article. A student may publish an entire dissertation chapter with minor edits as a journal article. And an author may republish with appropriate permissions a document that is rewritten for a different audience, changing the language to fit the new genre. All these examples of text recycling are usually considered to be acceptable. Given these points, let's reconsider Dr. Hotshot's options for reusing text in an introduction. In the first option, he would use his original text verbatim without citing the source. He thinks that because they are his words, he is free to repeat them in another paper. This reuse, however, would be unethical because it fails to acknowledge the source of the text and misleads the reader as to the originality of the passage. The same is true of the second option. However, if he rephrased the text and referenced the original paper, as in the third option, this would be acceptable. Putting the recycled text in quotation marks is also a valid option, but may not be a practical one to use multiple times in a scientific paper. Thus, the decision to reuse text depends on several factors that should be carefully weighed by the author: type and amount of text involved, prior publication and copyright considerations, usual practice in the field of study, such as reuse of methods descriptions, And if a substantial amount of text is reused, it's advisable to check if permission from the copyright holder is necessary. Even if you wrote the original words in a publication, the copyright was likely transferred to the publisher of your research article. There may also be work-for-hire instances in which your employer owns the original work. Another point to consider is that many journals now employ plagiarism checkers, and a small amount of recycled text, even if ethical, may trigger a red flag for your new submission. So it's a good idea to be upfront with the journal editor about any recycled text and include a statement in the paper about the reused material. Finally, you need to consider any co-authors of the original paper when thinking about reusing any portion in a second document. Thanks for watching, and let me know what you think in the comments.